Top 5 ARIA label mistakes. The first mistake I often see is not having the label part of the accessible name. That doesn't mean that the accessible name must match the label itself, but the label should be inside the accessible name. Here we have an example of an ARIA label that says give us a call, but the visible label is contact us. Now this violates success criterion 2.5.3, and when that happens, people using voice control won't be able to activate their control. That's why it is important to have the label inside the accessible name. Another mistake is adding ARIA labels for random elements either without a role or just generic elements that have no semantic meaning. This is very bad because 9 times out of 10 screen readers are going to ignore the ARIA label, and when the screen readers do actually announce an ARIA label, for example on a div with no role, it is going to throw them off the loop, or they're going to try to assign a role on the div. For example, I found out that VoiceOver gives the role of dialogue on a div if you have an ARIA label without a role. So never do that. If you need to add an ARIA label to an element, make sure that it has a role. In this example, we have a balloon that shows 5 notifications, and we have an ARIA label saying 5 notifications, and that's wrong. The screen reader is just going to skip, and it's not going to announce the element, or it's going to announce the source path of the SVG, which is wrong. Also, implicit roles are also okay. You can add ARIA labels to implicit roles. They don't have to be actually defined with the row element as well. Another mistake I often see is using redundant ARIA labels, meaning that you have great visible text for the button or the link, and then you add the exact same text for the ARIA label. This is very bad, even though it might seem harmless, because ARIA labels are not being able to be translated by browser plugins, and they also have a plethora of other issues, such as sometimes developers forget to update the ARIA label when the visible label is changed as well. So if you have a descriptive visible label and it doesn't disappear even on small devices, you do not need an ARIA label. Another mistake is adding an ARIA label that is not descriptive or helpful at all. For example, if you have a hamburger menu and you have your ARIA label of click here, this is going to be useless to the user, and it's going to create a plethora of other problems. So make sure that your ARIA labels are descriptive. Describing decorative images in ARIA labels is also a waste of time, and it brings no useful information to the user. For example, if you have a Facebook icon that leads to your company's Facebook profile, if the ARIA label just says Facebook icon, it's not going to be useful for the user at all. Instead, when you have a graphic icon or a graphic link, 9 times out of 10, you should describe the destination. So in this case, instead of a Facebook icon, it should be company Facebook profile page or just Facebook. In this way, the user will know where they're going to get redirected to. This lecture is part of the ARIA course I have on Udemy available for purchase. It is the highest rated course in the accessibility section on Udemy, and it has 4.8 stars and over 100 students. Feel free to enroll and ask me any questions that you have. Thank you.